Hey gang, welcome back again to Ken Tamplin Vocal Academy, where the proof is in the singing. I'm doing a new series, and the series is called Then and Now. And why I'm doing it is because I am juxtaposing great artists from their earlier years of performing to their later years of performing. Now, this is either just before they're passing or they're still with us today. The goal is not to make fun of them. The goal is to see how they matured over time. Did they fare well? And could they have done anything differently to take care of their voices? Okay, this is really important. Next up is George Michael. Just gonna dive right in. Here we go. I gotta say, I've seen George, I've only seen him live twice, but on TV stuff, live TV stuff, and some other stuff, and of course videos. The brother knows how to sing. I mean, the guy is just like album perfect, spot on, like almost every time. I've seen a couple times where he's moved it around a little bit, not much, but man, George Michael, I'm sorry, the guy's just great, man. So I had to stop for a minute because I was wowed by like looking at his live performance. Now I know some of this was actually kind of an edited thing, and I had to do some magic because a lot of the live stuff or whatever, there's a lot of stuff that gets blocked. And so I'm trying to get the best performances, maybe the same ones when they're younger as older, so we could really contrast the two and A-B them. And in this case, man, I'm just like, wow, George, dude. Now, by the way, I mean, so I'm never gonna dance again. Guilty feeling, got no rhythm. Though it's easy to pretend, I know you're not a fool. Right, he's a real guy, crystal clear, bright tone. So that was then, and this is right up to the later years, just before he passed. Now, what did you guys notice? Obviously, the voice was darker, thicker in the throat. He had less stretch, less agility, less elasticity in the sense of, I could have lived his dance forever, but now, who's gonna dance with me? Now, right? Say, by the way, I'm over-exaggerating. I just want you to kind of like really hear it. So there wasn't as much freedom. No freedom, 90 pun intended. But there wasn't enough as much freedom in the sound, but it's still great. Like you wouldn't really notice it that much other than, yeah, his voice sounds a little older. Now, when he passed, he wasn't that old. So we didn't really get to see him in his later years. So I don't think it's quite the same as like, I did one on Elton John. I don't know when these are gonna be released, but where Elton spanned some 50 years or whatever. And you've got to see him in his early years and later years. And so it's not quite as fair doing this with George, but it's still a really interesting indicator. Could something have been done? Yes, there's agility exercises. I cover this in my singing course if you guys are interested. I go through this with all of my students too, because I have a lot of different age demographics, and especially my older students. We work different exercises for a more matured voice in order to maintain elasticity in the chord so they don't get caught real kind of rigid and, you know, I don't know, just not a well-oiled machine, so to speak. But let's listen, but it's still incredible. Here we go. And I'm never gonna dance again. Guilty feet of God. Okay, here's then. Now Now, this isn't early Wham. This is still a little later. So this is closer to the end or whatever that means. Not no meaning, no disrespect. Here we go. All right, now, major respect, because as most artists do, as they age, they detune their music. And his music was in the original key on all this stuff, so he didn't detune it, and he is pitch perfect, spot on. So, like I'm saying, man, I mean, so here's another one from Ben. Let's check this out. I love this song. I loved that. I did a version of this. I don't think I'm gonna put my versions of stuff in the description. You can Google stuff I've done, but I've done this tune. I remember how hard it was to sing, not because the notes were so hard to sing, but the vibe and the phrasing was really tough. But anyway, let's keep going. Yeah, you got to do what you... Now, this is now. Okay, so they did take it down a full step. And now, by the way, one more thing I want to mention is if you notice too, in acoustic performances, a lot of times they'll do that. So I don't want to bust his chops for taking it down in an acoustic performance. The reason for that is because when we don't do things and tune them down a little bit, we lose the intimacy and we kind of have to sing really belty or real big and keep a lot more energy in something than taking it down a couple notches to be more intimate in acoustic performance, okay? So for you guys that are interested, I have a singing course. You can find it here, kentamplinvocalacademy.com, where, you know, I walk you guys through this stuff step by step. I have a great free singing forum of over 25,000 singers over there, all talking about how to get great at singing. And let's definitely stick around. Check out my next video.